Tonight, we're learning about a possible second abduction attempt in Bridgeton. Good evening. I'm Steve Savoie.
Tomorrow, the Department of Justice is expected to deliver its report on the Ferguson Police Department and their handling of the Michael Brown shooting. The report is expected to claim that the department has a racial bias. News 4's Deanna Zoga is live in Ferguson with more. Deanna?
Still needs to be done to reduce the number of scenes like we're looking at right here and the number of tragedies like Rashad's death.
Well, I think it goes back to one of the statements you made about opportunities.
Ferguson officer Mike Vernon remains paralyzed from the waist down with a bullet lodged in his spine. Despite that, he says he would return to active police duty the moment he could.
Where do you stand on what's going on between the governor and the legislature?
I support the governor in this matter.
You'd like to see some money back in your pocket and others' pocket to stimulate the economy?
I would love to see some money go back in my pocket. I get up every morning at 5 o'clock in the morning and hit that clock. I would love to see something go back in my pocket.
How excited would you be to see this area transformed into what we see
on
that poster board?
That would be a dream come true.
Melvin White wants to change the way our country pays tribute to King's legacy.
I have a dream.
I would have done a lot of dunking just like that at Kirkwood High, but the dunk was illegal back in the 70s.
You played in the wrong era. It cost you. It cost you dearly.
The two-hand set shot was about all we could do.
And you were a master at it.
Limited my game.
You've overcome, though. Mm-hmm.
And Sharon, we'll hear from the Blues, who last night took a 2-0 lead on the Stanley Cup champion LA Kings. Maybe they can return the favor and sweep the Kings this year.
You needed another reason to like Kevin Green. There it is right there. And if it feels like I'm a little bitter, it's because I'm a lot bitter.
Throw the objective journalism out the
Absolutely.
Window with this, right?
I hope that the Coliseum crumbles before they get to play the first game. Nobody in it, but I'd like to see it reduced to rubble before they get that first game played.
You better take us to break before he implodes. If you've been on social media in the past 24 hours, you know how upset many Rams fans are. In fact, you may be angry yourself. I've consoled a few. Hopefully I did a good job. But today, one local sports bar is sifting through the chaos in search of a silver lining.
Maggie, we've been focused on, and for good reason, because of all the damage, on the main terminal. We have not talked about the east terminal, the terminal that houses so many of those Southwest Airlines gates. How much, if any, damage was done to the east terminal?
We're going to take our final break of the evening coming up. When we come back, we will have closing remarks. You're watching a live statewide broadcast of the Missouri GOP governor's debate from the campus of Lindenwood University in St. Charles. We're right back.